Being gay isn't normal, and that's actually awesome. Stop emotionally reacting to the word normal and think about what it means. Gay people in the past, even when dealing with those who were very accepting, were forced to reckon with the fact that being gay isn't actually normal. Normal means that it's common, it's typical, it's the regular thing. You can't possibly create something great if you're just doing the regular thing. In the past, gay people have been the ones who pushed boundaries in entertainment, culture, and many other places, taking us away from mundane thinking and mundane living. Those of us who were out of the closet absolutely had a different lifestyle. We did not live according to the same sets of social rules as straight people. You know, straight people. The people who make up 95% of the population, yeah, we did not live according to their rules. Yet, in the past, we, and when I say we, I mean fellow gay people, in the past we'd get offended at being told that gay people have different lifestyles, and now people get even more offended at that because gay people have been offered the social lubrication of gay marriage to actually have a bit more social normalcy, and I guess for some people, being considered normal is the most important thing. And now, since so many gay people seem to be embracing the idea of being normal, we're losing that ability to push boundaries by simply being creative like what culturally used to be in our nature, and are instead becoming totalitarian in this attempt to promote identity politics in order to make being gay artificially be considered normal because the progressive stack and this idea that we should always have equality of outcome. So again, being gay isn't normal. As I've said before, normal is boring. Normal is mundane. Why would we want to bring ourselves down to the lowest common denominator? That's stupid. And then once we've become the lowest common denominator, we no longer even offer anything that people of any demographic can enjoy. It means we would have lost our creative edge. And I see that happening in spades. People do enjoy things that are different. If it offends you that you are looked at as exotic, I seriously think there's something wrong with you. How could you possibly be positively elevated more than being considered exotic? Different and beautiful, or different and cool? How could someone possibly be offended at that? What kind of crazy ideology does someone have in order to look at being considered exotic as offensive? Or is it the idea that we're considered entertainment? Well, you know, tough shit. Life is a theater, and if you wear it, it's a costume. Own it. Stop complaining about not being able to see because the power went out. Light a candle or turn on a flashlight, you dim twit. Pushing boundaries is fine. That's been going on for a long time. But as soon as we start becoming dogmatic about it, as soon as we start pushing for equality of outcome for LGBT, even though we only represent less than 5% of the population, or we start pushing for equality of outcome for everyone except for those who are in the majority, we're not pushing anything creative whatsoever. There's nothing creative about an ideology. I repeat, there's nothing creative about an ideology. In general, an ideology is about groupthink. If you want to prove that you're worth being noticed, then do something awesome. And then don't complain because you were noticed for doing something awesome.